أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We read in the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم about Arabia before Islam, and we call it Jahiliyyah, which is a combination of simplicity and ignorance, illiteracy, closer to nature, fitra, and also arrogance and so on. Anyway, it's Jahiliya always when we say Ash'ar al-Jahili, the poet of that period and so on. And many scholars questioned why God has chosen that spot from other spots to deliver the last message, the message of Islam, the message of La ilaha illallah, to this area. Of course, Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalata. God knows better his business. On the other hand, we know that there's 115 messengers of God all over the globe, and 124,000 prophets from the beginning of man on earth till now, till the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And many false prophets will come later on, which had happened. So let us see what is Arabia morals before Islam. There's bad ones, which is very obvious. They are bad, of killing, violence, invading, and female infanticide, and many other bad things happen. Usury, prostitution. But we know that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that his mission is to fulfill and refine and complete the moral values. So there are many good moral values in Arabia. For example, love for freedom. Those people never been subjugated to foreign powers like the Greek or Romans the Persians. They were in the periphery, but not in Arabia itself, in the middle or in Mecca. So this love of freedom is very important for any message to grow and propagate. Also, they have the talent of expressing themselves very clearly, concisely, with a few words carry a lot of big meanings. And this is what we call al-fasaha and al-balagha. Also, they were courageous people, and they are good in fighting. We call it furusiyya. And they have very sharp memories with little statics from the civilizations and so on, fresh air and uncontaminated environment. So they had very strong memory, and that's recorded all the poetry we know nowadays. Also, they have a very strong will, and they execute what they believe should be done. So irada qawiya. Also, they are realistic. They are not dreamers. And the desert, with the scarcity of resources, made them learn how to live very simple life, shadaful aish. And they were away from the philosophy and the previous religions, though with the caravans and so on, they were exposed in Persia and the Roman territories, and in the south also to other cultures and civilizations. Of the good morals of Jahiliyyah, the generosity, which is well known till now, the Arabs are very generous, not for business, not for those they know, as we do nowadays. We invite the rich and famous and the ones who do not need to be invited, but we have business with them. So the generosity and hosting any stranger who is on the road to somewhere and so on, they make big dinners for them. And we know the story of Hatem al-Ta'i and his horse, and the Roman emperor, he wanted that horse, but he slaughtered to feed the delegation. He didn't have anything else to offer. Also, they have a characteristic which is can be translated as dignity, عزت النفس and الإباء. We see it very clearly in their poetry, like the one I mentioned in the previous session, ذو الإصبع العدواني, when he said, إني أبي أبي ذو محافظة وابن أبي أبي من أبيين. So this is something very, very great. They don't have those weak personalities and timid or whatever. So, عزت النفس and الإباء. Also, they have a characteristic of learning wisdom during life, and those we call them حكماء العرب, the wise people of Arabia. And the one I cited already, he is one of those حكماء العرب, ذو الإصبع العدواني. He's also lived in the Jahiliyyah. And forbearing is one of their characteristic. And of course, when you are free and you have all these qualities, you don't have to lie. Lying is characteristic of civilized and big cities and so on. So they are straightforward, honest. They don't lie. And we know a story of Abu Sufyan. He was the arch enemy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was in Damascus and he met the emperor of the Byzantine, and he asked him about Muhammad. Here Abu Sufyan knows Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a perfect in everything, so he loved to lie, but his being aib or being, he prohibited, he cannot lie, because Arabia would say he's, you know, he made a lie. So the truthfulness is one of the characteristic of Arabia, as-sidq. And also al-amana, we know many times wars been waged because of someone been entrusted with belonging to others and refused to give it to the Romans and so on. So wars has been waged. So there are many, many good qualities in Arabia, which Islam came and promoted these good values and refine it from being self-serving or being for arrogance or show off, to be all dedicated to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there's here a shift. You're honest because honesty is good, but God commanded us to be honest, and so on. So hopefully we will come to talk about a couple of the wise men of Arabia, حكماء العرب, and starting with our poet ذو الإصبع العدواني. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.